Well, yesterday the paddock was deeply saddened by the death of racing driver Maria de Valota. She was found in a hotel room in Seville, and it seems as though she died from natural causes. Last year, she suffered serious facial and head injuries after an accident while she was testing with Marussia, but earlier in February this year, she was cleared to drive again. Now, Eddie, she wasn't really just loved for her racing talent, but also she was such a courageous girl, wasn't she?
I think that's the perfect word, courageous, tenacious. She had everything. She came from a racing family, of course. But, you know, she was a girl in a man's world, and we can go on about that in a second. But, I mean, what she did and how she came back writing this great book of hers about life as a gift, it's been announced, and, of course, that'll be a bestseller. But I think it's the tragic loss. Yesterday was a very somber paddock here in Japan. We know what it's like. It's a very tight-knit community here, Formula One. We travel the world. We're hugely competitive against each other on the track. But deep down, when we're together, it's a great bond, and we've lost a great friend and a true champion. Just the analogy, and I make it quite clearly, she came into a male-dominated sport. It's like putting a lady in against Mike Tyson and asking her to do 15 rounds. It was a huge task, and then to come back and the courage to say she was going to come back and race after that huge accident, that's why she will always be very deep in my heart, and I will always remember her.
Certainly loved and admired by the whole paddock.
Well, the greatest impression she's left behind is that she always had a smile on her face, no matter what all she went through. And for me, it just looks like it's not too long ago where we were all announced as FIA ambassadors in Paris, and we spent a day and a half together. And she was just so excited about what all she wanted to do. And then, of course, the terrible accident came, and everyone thought that she'd probably just stop with motor racing, but not at all. To the contrary, she was more than ever determined, I'd say, to get back into motorsport and to move things. And I think that's what she leaves behind, that you always have to have the strength and courage, no matter what happens to you, believe in your goal and go for it.
I think when I first heard the news yesterday, it was complete and utter shock, because we'd been in touch not that long ago, and she was so positive and so excited about so many great things that were happening in her life, and suddenly to hear that kind of really devastated me. But now it's much easier to look at her and to say, okay, she had an extra year and a half after the accident, and you start remembering the positive things, and she's left behind a legacy. She wrote her book, Life is a Gift, so she's told her story, and she will never be forgotten. So that's a positive way of looking on something very tragic.